गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, इट इज द 10th लेक्चर ऑफ द सीरीज ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल मशीन्स। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द रोटेटिंग मैग्नेटिक फील्ड पार्ट टू। इन यस्टरडे क्लास वी डिस्कस अबाउट द रोटेटिंग मैग्नेटिक फील्ड, बट देयर वी have used the analytical method to calculate the resultant rotating magnetic field and its direction. In rotating magnetic field, in yesterday class we have seen ki we are putting three coils, one is the AA dash and then BB dash and CC dash. All three are putting in the stationary magnetic field, and when these coils are apart 120 mechanical degree, and when these coils are moving in the stationary magnetic field, then they will induce the EMF, and that is known as the our three phase connection phenomena. So you can see here, if I am putting coil A, A and S here, so it's the flux direction is the perpendicular here, and the for B and B dash coil is the flux direction is here, and C, C dash coil is the flux direction is in this direction. So all three fluxes are represented here. It is the A and B and C. In industry, it is represented by the red and yellow and blue. So the three phase winding place 120 electrical degree apart in the stator and may be connected by the either by star and delta connections. In the star and delta connection, how we produce the three phase supply, we have already discussed in the lecture 8 about the detailed discussion we have already done in lecture 8. So you see, when the stator is energized from the three phase voltage, then it will produce the rotating magnetic field, and we have seen that rotating magnetic field magnitude is 1.5 of maximum, and this magnitude is constant, but its direction is continuously rotated here. And we have seen in analytical method it is rotating clockwise. So the direction of rotating of magnetic field basically depends on the phase sequence. It means if I change my phase equation, I put my B is here and C is here. In this case, the direction of rotating field will be anticlockwise. So now we will discuss about our second method, which is known as the graphical method of rotating magnetic field. What we are doing here, because here due to three phase, we are getting here three fluxes, and three is the AC fluxes. So first flux is phi A, which is represented by phi maxima sine omega t. Second is phi m sine omega t minus 120, because it is lagging behind 120. And third is phi max sine omega t minus 240, because it is lagging by 240 degree. So these flux we will draw graphically here, and we will see first how we can draw these fluxes, and then we'll check the magnitude and direction of flux at 4 point. So first we will draw our first flux phi A. So you see that it started from 0 and then it is 180, again goes maximum and it becomes 360. Like this way it will be drawn. Then go in the second part, which is the flux B. So it is behind 120. So I will start my drawing from 120 and it's go maxima, then it's down is minima, and it is go like this way, again is the maxima here 390, and it goes minima here. I can draw in the back side also. So it's the 30, then is the 60 and 90, so it's become maximum, and then it becomes 30, then minus 30 and minus 60 is becomes zero here. When we are talking about the third flux, though, it will start 240. So I will draw from that particular place and go its maxima and minima like this way, And if I draw in the back side, so it's the 30 and 60 and maximum, it becomes maximum 90. Then again 30 and 60 and 90 becomes 0. Then I will draw is the 30, and then at 60, so it's not maximum here. Maximum will becomes is minus 30. So it will be like this way. It is here and it is here. So it's the value of is sine 60 here, and it is value of sine minus 60 here. So you can see these are values minus 3 under root 3 by 2 phi maximum, because phi maximum is denoted here. It is the phi maximum. Here is the phi maximum, and the plus is 3 under root 3 root 2 y under root 3 by 2 multiplied by phi max. So that these are the values. So now I will consider here four cases, 1, 2, 3, and 4. I will see here what will be the magnitude of rotating flux and what will be the direction. Same I will check at the point 2, point 3 again I will check the magnitude and the direction of flux, and point 4 also check. So these are the four cases. So first we will discuss our first case. In first case, omega t equal to 0, and this case phi a becomes 0, this becomes minus 3 by 2, and it becomes plus 3 under root upon 2, and it's the multiplied by the maximum. So we will draw here. We will see it's the our first part, flux is the second part, is third part, and the angle between these two 120. Here it is also 120, or here it is also 120. Is it okay? But the phi a is 0, so I will put my phi a is here, but you see the phi b is minus under root 3 by 2. So you see here in the back direction, this one is the phi b. Is it okay? And phi c is in this direction, in given, because it is positive and in the direction of phi c. So now I will calculate the resultant of these, and resultant of these is given by here. So what I will use here, I will use the law of parallelogram here, and the vector magnitude is same here, 3 by 2, phi m is 3 by 2, root 3 by 2 is phi m here. So I can calculate this equal to, it is nothing but, you know, 2a cos alpha by 2. So you see here, 2a, it means this vector is a here, and this one is the alpha here. So I put here 2, and then it's a is nothing but root 3 by 2 phi m, and cos, and is the alpha is 60 here divided by 2. So from that I can calculate here it is 3 by 2 phi m, and its direction is in this direction. You can see in this direction. Same we have seen in analytical method. Is it okay? So first case is matching with analytical method also, and we are able to draw the phasor diagram, and we can calculate the same way. Now we will see the second case. So in the second case, what is happening? Second case is the 60 degree. So if I am putting sine 60 here, so the my phi a becomes equal to this, phi b becomes equal to c, but this becomes is 180, so it's 0 here. So the phi a you draw in this direction, phi b is the negative direction. It's okay. And then again I will calculate the resultant, and for calculate the resultant I will again use the law of parallelogram, and it's again becomes equal to 3 by 2 phi m, and you can see the direction of resultant here. So is it, so its magnitude again is same. Now we will see the third case. In third case we are considering 120, and calculate the value of this becomes plus here. This is equal to 0 because phi m sine 120 minus 120, so it becomes 0, and this becomes equal to minus 3 root by 2 phi m. So what I will do, my first value is this, b is 0 here, so I put b is 0, but my flux in this c is in the backward direction, so I draw here. Is it okay? And now again I will calculate my resultant here using the same law, and you are getting the same value here. It means its magnitude is constant. Its magnitude is constant. So it's the direction, and you see it's direction in this direction. You see this one is the direction here. Is it okay? So now we will see the fourth case. In fourth case, we are considering 180. This becomes equal to 0. This becomes is equal to positive, and this becomes equal to negative. And it's a very simple mathematics. So you put your value in this in the positive given, but c is in the negative direction, and the resultant will in this direction. So I will put again the law of parallelogram and get the same value, and you see the direction in this direction. Is it okay? So what I am saying here, you see the slide number second here. In this case, in the first case, with omega t equal to 0, then our flux direction or our magnetic field direction is this one. In the second case, when we are at the omega t equal to 60 degree, in this direction. In the third case, when omega t becomes equal to 120 degree, then the magnitude is here 3 by 2 maximum, and the direction in this direction. Is it okay? Here magnitude is also 3 by 2 phi max. Here is 3 by 2 phi max. So magnitude is, and all cases are 3 by 2 of maximum. But you see in this first case the direction is upward, and then second case the direction in this direction, third is here, and fourth is the downward. So here we again see the same result, just like the analytical method. It is clockwise, it is rotating in the clockwise direction. If I change these two interchange, if it becomes C and it becomes B, then the direction will be changed here. So the direction of rotation is dependent on the phase sequence. Is it okay? So now I will put some concluding remark on the rotating magnetic field, because it is very important phenomena to understand the working principle of induction motor. So when a three phase winding, so this winding, I am talking about the winding of three phase AC. So it's the mechanically displaced 120 degree from each other, is energized from a three phase supply. A rotating magnetic field of constant magnitude, we have seen this one, and where the phi m the maximum flux due to any of phase, whichever phase we are using. This field is such that is the pole do not remain in a fixed position on the stator. I am talking about the flux, the field or flux produced here, which is not fixed here, but it is continuously rotating. Its position is continuously shifting, and that is the reason to it is called a rotating magnetic field. And the rotation speed is given by this formula, ns equal to 120 f upon p, where ns is nothing but it is called as a synchronous speed in rpm, revolution per minute, and f is nothing but the supply frequency, and p is the number of poles. So if we are using our the principle of rotating magnetic field in our induction motor, basically, so it is nothing but this rotating magnetic field cuts the rotor winding, because we all know in the rotor we are putting our conductors there. So that is the rotor winding, and therefore the induced EMF in rotor winding, according to Faraday's law of the electromagnetic induction, since the rotor winding are short circuited, because these are enclosed in a circuit, and therefore due to induced EMF, current flows in the rotating winding. The rotor current produces another magnetic field. It means a torque it produces as a result of interaction of those two magnetic field. One magnetic field, which is the rotating magnetic field, another magnetic field is due to the induced EMF in rotator windings. So what we can say, it is interaction of rotor current with synchronous rotating magnetic fields that produces the electromagnetic torque in rotor conductor, and rotor starts moving. That's the basic principle to work a induction motor. So when we are talking about our induction motor, then we have to understand the basic concept of the rotating magnetic field. I think lecture 9 on lecture 10, in both lecture we have discussed the method about we have discussed the method of rotating magnetic field, including analytical method as well as our graphical method, and I think you understood the basic concept of rotating magnetic field. So thank you. If you have any problem, then you can write a mail to me on sham@gwhe.ac.in. Thank you.